Hello everyone, welcome to Doom, the very first Doom. We're playing the very first Doom, because I have recently purchased the very latest Doom, and I wanted to start again. We recently did a Hexen series, so in the same vein, we're going to play old Doom in new mode. Now, I did just start an episode on Nightmare mode, but I did not realise quite how irresponsibly bad that game. I mean, it's constantly spawning in enemies, it's constantly attacking you, there's no ammo, there's no chance to survive. I died about 2 times in the first 3 levels. That's how difficult it is. So I thought, you know what? That's just going to get a little bit boring. It's going to get over and over again. We want to get through this game. It's a reasonably, ooh, that was weird, small game if we're playing at modern speeds. And I do have the HUD on down there, as you can see, because without it, we don't really get a good, you know, we don't get a good view of what's actually going on. Just our ammo in small view and our health in small view. So I've got this up just so that we can see it, so that you can see it more importantly. I mean, I'd like to be able to see it too, if that's okay. Already been shot, good start. But yeah, mostly I just kind of prefer it. It takes away some screen space, but I couldn't figure out how to put any more information on the screen. So there you go. Yeah, so as I said, did do a nightmare mode attempt, but you know, I'd already died once just getting to this point on nightmare mode, because they were just constantly spawning in. I thought that on nightmare mode they just respawned, which would make some sense, but that is not the case. I was gonna say I'm gonna keep using my pistol here, but in fact I'm not. I didn't really want to pick that up, but we didn't have too much of a choice. Ooh, big noise. Apologies for the large sound when you pick up a secret. That is new to the Zandronum game engine, I think. But, you know, it is what it is. I was going to say I'm going to keep using my pistol, but there's no need to keep using your pistol when the enemies are dropping shotguns. Hello! Yeah, I thought that Nightmare Mode just respawned the zombies, basically, and anything else. And I was going to say, you know, if this really happened, if our Marine had somehow been the only survivor of somebody else opening up the Hellmouth underneath them. Excuse me, I'm pretty sure that's supposed to bring that down now. It's making the noise. I was fairly sure that that brought that down. I'll tell you what it probably is. Something else brings that down. But it is not the case. They're just constantly spawning and it's ridiculously unfair. As it says, when you try to play it, and I dare say there are people on the internet currently playing original Doom. That's what it drops. There we go. On nightmare mode. So go ahead and watch them if you seem to think that that's a good idea. But personally, I am not down with this at all. Morty Vicar. Right, it's in that corner. So we can get there. I think it's one of these line deaths here. I've talked about the engine ad nauseam in the Hexen series, so go check that out. And honestly, Hexen is a very much more accomplished game than this is. But do remember that apart from Wolf 3D, Wolfenstein, this game was the defining, 3D shooter of its generation, which was the first generation of this sort of game. So when I finished this level on Nightmare Mode, I had 40% health. I didn't even get all the kills there. That was a mistake. Now I have 104% health. So I think we're actually going to at least get through this game. Hexen, it was kind of, it stretched itself out. There was more content naturally in Hexen, because it's a bigger game and there's more to do and there's more to talk about, and on hard mode it's not actually impossible. This being Doom, it's not impossible, except on nightmare mode when it appears to be. So I didn't want to artificially inflate the series just by dying a lot and, you know, constantly redoing the same part of the same level over and over again. It seemed to make more sense to try and get through the game, show off the content. It's very dark on my recording, actually, which is interesting, because on my actual screen, it's really light. I'll try and address that. I might be able to do it in post-processing on YouTube itself. Also, the other thing is that I was rushing so much to get through it before, because it was ridiculously impossible to play, but I missed a lot of the actual content in the first place. You know, I didn't managed to find the secrets. I know there's a secret around here somewhere, but I cannot for the life of remember where it is. Like, there's something that opens that, and then there's something that opens this. Can't remember what opens this, although he does like to make a very suggestive noise when I try to. Let's have a look on the map. We do have a map. That's nice. We'll come back to it. But it means I can kill everything in the level and then explore the level. Rather than continue to run. Which I guess is the point of the nightmare mode, is that the idea is you just keep running for your life, right? But you know, there would be constant teleporter sounds. There would be constant things to run from. There'd be things behind you. There'd be things in front of you. I've put it now on the hardest mode that is not actually just going to stretch out the series without stretching out the content. And I don't want to do that. I don't think that's necessarily fair. On the viewers, who I, despite having a few of, do care about. But it's also not really fair on me. Big noise, I apologise. Because I don't want to keep dying and getting frustrated with the level. And I don't want to keep save scumming it to get through a part. In fact, save scumming on nightmare mode is probably as bad as it is good. Oh, hello. I just sort of stared at that guy and he shot me. So I was explaining in the episode that I didn't actually keep, because it was bad, that I played this game when I was a kid. And I played it on, with God mode on, and I played it with a keyboard. And, yeah, just the keyboard, straight up the keyboard. I was going to say, and the mouse, and duh. No, not the mouse. That's the point. This game was originally designed with keyboard players in mind. I can hear you growling. So, playing it with a keyboard made sense. And, of course, in the 90s, we didn't really have any idea that we were going to end up with a game like Quake, which is, again, by the same actual people, by id, changing the way we actually play this game, i.e., you know, Quake with its looking up and down with its actual 3D environments, gave us the impetus to develop a control scheme that would let us take advantage of being able to jump down on top of enemies and beat the ever-loving crap out of them. Now, I want to get in there as well. So we're going to try and remember all these secrets. Because, again, in nightmare mode, I was legging it through. I couldn't get anywhere without being beaten up by millions and millions of constantly respawning enemies. I will try and see if I can find a way of reducing the volume of that secret sound. But unfortunately, it may just involve reducing the volume of the game. Which I'm going to do anyway, because I record my audio, my voice separately from the game audio, and I do that. Ooh, that was actually really bad timing. That was an Isaac dodge right there. Just so that I can, you know, equalize the volumes, sort of post-equalize the volumes, rather than having to figure out what it's going to sound like when I've finished recording and try and do it from there. So I use my pistol there. Hello. Because we were not in so much danger as we needed to worry about it. But I will pick this health up. So, yeah. Quake. Quake redefined, I think, it's fair to say, the way that we, you know, play these games, because it was the first time that we had a literal advantage to being able to look up and down. In this game, it does have some advantage, like you saw with that lift. You can see what's at the top of it, but, you know, big FND, all right? Now, where the hell is the button that opens that thing? Is it just a case of running? Does something open it while you're in there? I honestly can't remember. I know there's a thing here. This is stressful. Decent amount of armor. Everything is oomph noises. Ah! Probably all yelling at the screen right now, telling me what's going on. I'm going to probably put a cut in this episode, like I did with Hexen. I don't really want to waste your time. This is going to be a quick series, basically. So I would like to get through it nice and quickly. I'd like it to be sort of a brief mini-series, a historical look back before we get into the real reason I'm playing this game, which is as a sort of precursor to the new Doom. Shoot that, no. So I'm going to keep looking around, see if I can remember how that door over there works, and I'll bring you back when I have discovered the secret. Hmm. I've discovered the secret. It was, in fact, just straight up a door that I hadn't noticed. I thought it opened this wall. In fact, it opens this wall. Okie dokie. We press this button. That opens the other door up here. On this corner. Hello. You migrated very quickly after I opened that door. Or you spawned in. I suspect that was not the case. Taking a bit of damage there that I'm not proud of. Again, apologies for the loud secret sounds. Even this newfangled dodging around that I keep doing is not... It's 100 health, right? Excuse me. That was not a soul sphere. That was supercharge, if you'd care to look in the corner. This is what we like to see, the chain gun. Chain gun is pretty loud, going to be honest right now. So, cover your ears. Right, good. We found that. Again, it's just a very obvious patch on the wall. For anyone who's played games before, that should be clear, but obviously for me, it was not so much. Now we need to remember where the other thing, and I think through here, where the imps were. There were imps at the back. Where are you? Not that one, that was a different secret. There was imps at the back, and then I think you just press one of the walls. No? I was fairly sure it came out here. It definitely comes out here. Hmm. Show your secrets. Shoot it. I expect that you're supposed to find that by missing the imp, but apparently I'm an amazing shot, so that doesn't happen. Press this. Get chainsaw. So that's us basically sorted for the next while. Probably not going to use the chainsaw. That sounds like a bit of a bad idea. Although if we get the berserk mode, we're invincible for a while. If we get invincibility, in fact. We're also invincible for a while, but I'm thinking more of the Berserk mode, which is great fun. And in fact, one of the reasons I like Doom 3 is that the Berserk mode was really well done. They really made good use of fairly modern modern ideas at the time to make that work. A lot of people give Doom 3 a bad rap. I found it quite difficult, which is good. At least the first time through. And honestly, it's worth playing once. If you never play it twice, if you don't like it, fine. I mean, I can understand... There's supposed to be a baddie in there. I can understand people that did not like... Oh, I missed a secret! You're going to be sad. You're going to be salty with me. That's fine. I can understand not liking Doom 3. It was pretty good, but it was not amazing. It was... A lot of the criticism was to do with the way that they handled fear in the game, i.e. there's a lot of jump scares in it. I think I'd rather be shot by him than eaten by that, if you don't mind. And that's fair. They use darkness a lot. They use shadows a lot. But, I mean, these things... First of all, so did this Doom. We didn't use shadows. Didn't have them. So they improved on what this original Doom was doing. They also told the story better, which is what I was trying to get at earlier on. I.e., when I was playing as a kid... I ran around the game, I had God mode on, or I played with the noclip cheat and stuff like that. Just to, you know, play with the game rather than play the game, if that makes sense. There you go, you can have that. Didn't really understand what was happening, you know. The game doesn't really tell you its own story until you finish an episode. It didn't tell you at the start. I mean, you saw me start the game. That's it. That's all the exposition you ever get. I.e. none, right? I didn't really follow. I didn't know what's happening. I just knew that there were people shooting me and I was supposed to shoot them. Easy. I can deal with that. I'm not going to do that just yet. I'm going to try and get this down first. But Doom 3 actually started off in story mode, which is itself a fairly modern storytelling device in games. To have a section of the game that is not... Oh my god. You know, it's not the violent, it's not the gameplay part, it's the story part. Previous games had things like, cutscenes. Cutscenes are fairly common, especially in, sort of, the games in between really good 3D graphics, but just after... We got capable of putting FMV, full motion video, in games. We started telling the story with FMV. What? We'll talk about that. With FMV. Sort of separately, right? That's the noise I wanted to hear, because that means we can go in here. Big noise, careful. This is a secret, so we're going to hear the noise, is what I'm saying. But FMV, of course, is not interactive. Here's another full health thing. Soul Sphere, apparently. That's not a secret? Excuse me? FMV is not interactive, you just have to watch. Oh, very well. That's happening. Apologies for the jump scare. Not interactive. It's all that matters, basically. Yeah, FMV is not interactive. You get to watch a small film that somebody has pre-recorded, often to great effect. Like, I'm not trying to lambast the concept of FMV. It worked really well and still can do. But... ah! We're dropping so much ammo in this mode that it's kind of unfair that we are considerably more powerful than the entire rest of the world, apparently. When games started to be able to render the video that they wanted you to see in their own engine, that's when, you know, the world became a better place. Incidentally, you may recall in the Hexen series that I said you could press switches without actually being near them, and I thought that you couldn't, and it turned out you can. But in Hexen, if you recall, they had... well, I'm stuck. In Hexen, if you recall, back to the start of the level, by the way. Apologies. They deactivated the switch until the switch was ready to be used, using scripting. In this game, no such thing. You didn't have that choice. The switch was always usable, even if you couldn't see it, as long as you could interact with the line def that, you know, supported it. There you are. I'm pretty glad that we picked up the chain gun in the last... I'm just going to use it. Everything just melts under it, so I don't see why I shouldn't. Where are you lot coming from? Because we have plenty of shotguns on the ground, everything's dropping a clip, and it takes less than 10 bullets to kill a thing that drops 10 bullets, so what the heck ever. Use the shotgun for a while, because there's a lot of it on the ground. There's a lot of it, a bear! Yeah, you'll recall that we said, you know, you... can still... ow! Whoa, look at my face! Unbelievable, that was horrible. That was more scary than the fucking legions of hell over here. Yeah, you can't press a switch, but you can press a switch in this game is what I'm saying, so you don't have to jump into that pit to get through to the switch. Unfortunately, it looked like there's no way out of the other one, so there you go. At least this soul sphere is now, useful. Can we shoot these fuckers? No. So, the ability of Doom 3 to have an interactive introduction to the whole story of the game, which is completely overlooked in original Doom, in my opinion. I actually explained a lot. I wasn't that young when I played Doom 3, obviously, because it isn't as old. But having done so, to now understand because it was made by id, you at least get the impression that the original developers were involved in it. They're trying to retell the story that they'd already told, right? So we have to step out and back into that to trigger it, which is a bit weird, but okay. And they did. And they did it quite well, in my opinion, for the time, for id. I mean, id don't really go... it says supercharge. Id don't really go too far in for... or didn't. Go too far in for subtlety, for a start. Or, you know... I guess subtlety is what I'm saying. It's not like it was ever going to be an Amnesia. And I think that's okay. It was always an arcadey sort of game. It had an arcadey sort of story. And using darkness and jump scares and, at the time, the shadows, which were turn-offable in Doom. Remember that shadows could be switched off in Doom 3. Die. Good. together made a game that was in the spirit of this one, I think. Look how much space I had to run away. I just fell off the side. I'm pretty sure there's no way out of that, and apologies if you know of one, but there was a minor discussion on Doom 3 between then and then, so we're okay. And again, I'm probably gonna, if I die, I'm gonna be redoing the level, unless it's a hugely long level, which is sort of logically separated into large segments, which themselves could have been levels, except for the fact that they decided not to put a break in. I might save in between. I have played this game before. So here's an example of using darkness to scare the shit out of you. Doom. Right? So it's not like they're above it, and it was not like it was unprecedented use of darkness. Oh, we go through ammo on this thing pretty quickly. Use of darkness by id to, you know, tell their story. It's almost titillate. They're trying to titillate you in the scare parts instead of the usual, you know, happy parts. So, Doom 3 ticked many boxes for me. And now, if you play it and you look back, you say, this is, there's a lot of cheap tactics here. But if you consider the time it was made, much like this game, you would say, this is actually not all that bad. I can see what they've done here. They've made a good effort. Other games have done a similar thing better. Of that, there is no doubt. And I would not, you know, try to argue with you about that. Amnesia, I mentioned, I think it's approximately as old as Doom 3. And as with many indie games versus big company type titles, the indie game has turned out to be way better than, you know, the big company managed. But that's not to say that the big name company didn't do well. They put a lot of time and effort, and maybe they didn't have the passion for it. Maybe they were doing something different from what the fans would have expected. Partial invisibility. Can you not make that noise, though? I don't think that makes it a bad game. So you should play it once, because the story that it tells is the story of Doom. The original story of Doom. Retold using not FMV. You know, straight into the... If I'm passing invisible, how are you such a good shot? Straight into the fully immersive story type tactic. And at some point, we get a secret. So yeah, go play Doom 3. After this, we will be playing Big Doom, New Doom, Doom 2016. Which I expect will also retell the same story in its own way. Can't remember how to get into there. Let's have a look. Minus? Minus. And F and... F. There we go. Let's have a look. Where are we going to be? This is another one of those secrets that I remember exactly what it looks like, but I can't remember the heck of me how to get into it. You have to get that bridge to go up. There's a secret switch somewhere. Where? Out here? Let's go back through that door. No, I don't want to be... Nope. Bear with me. See, everything's not respawning, so I'm quite happy. Like, it's not like I have to take a leap of faith. I'm pretty sure you... There's a positive action required to open that door. Oh, you can just open that. Fair enough. Another chainsaw. I don't really need it. Also, there's more kills to be had. So. I may be conflating this level with a later one, which has a... Yeah, I think I am, actually. So. Thinking about this all wrong. I'm trying to remember. Trying to remember how it is that we get into... that place from this direction. It's a secret somewhere. Secret, secret, secret. Where are you? Is it in here? No. So over there, somewhere. There it is. Hey. I can hear you. Behind the walls. Oh, I know where that guy is. That's the one I couldn't shoot before. There is a secret. There is a way into here. No, it's this. Where the heck is that switch, though? Maybe it's just on the back of one of those pillars. Oh no, these are sprite pillars. It's not going to be those. Man. I'll bring you back when I've figured this out. This is about 25 minutes anyway, so at the end of this, when I figure this out, we'll end the level, and I'll probably see you next time. So join me in a minute, and then join me in the next episode. Hello everyone, I have rediscovered it. When we open this one, which takes us to the Soul Sphere in the first place, two of these open. I remembered that just as I was wandering around here. So you have to come right around here and leg it really fast. Open this secret. So I think it actually goes in the other direction. We do get a rocket launcher here, which is amazing. Then you can go through there. Notice it didn't switch weapon. That was a really annoying addition to games. Do you want to switch weapons whenever you pick one up? Oh, I'm going to say no. And also go fuck yourself. Backpack full of ammo is pretty nice. That is what raises the other thing. We do take some damage there, which is unavoidable. But that's okay, because it's worth it. And also we have plenty of HP. And plenty of armor, actually. That raises this. That opens this. We kill that. Another secret. I apologize for the big noises that we'll make. This has already been emptied, because we're amazing and knew what was coming. And then I've got the splash damage that I was asking for in the episode I didn't record. Bloody marvelous. Anything here now? We're going to explode these barrels, lest they explode us. And then this happens, that's right. This is like fighting Monstro in a small room. You stick to the sides so that you've got enough room to get around the shots that are coming towards you. Ta-da! Picked up four shotgun shells. I had 91 shotgun shells, and I picked up four shotgun shells, and then I had 100. Right, so. Thank you for watching this episode. Thank you for revealing my secret at that stage. And I will join you in the next when we go into the secret exit. I'll see you then. Oh, come on.